What's up, y'all? Happy Monday. Y'all know what time it is. You know what time it is. I don't know why you playing. It's scripture of the week, and y'all know I'm bringing it to you. If you're a true Cincinnati native, then you already know where I'm at. This the indicator right here. This fountain is the indicator. So if you know where I'm at, put it down in the comments when you see the video so I can know that you know we Cincinnati peoples. But anyway, we going into the scripture, y'all. This scripture, I believe, is going to encourage someone. It definitely encouraged me to look back on some things with God. But it's from James chapter 1, verse 2 through 4. And this is what it says. It says, "Consider it pure joy, my brothers and sisters, whenever you face trials of many kinds. Believe, because you know that the testing of your faith produces perseverance. Let perseverance finish its work so that you may be mature and complete, not lacking anything." So let's even think about that scripture. I know someone who probably is not familiar with the Bible will probably be like, "What do you mean, consider it pure joy, my brothers and sisters, whenever you face trials of many kinds?" Because when you think of a trial or when you think of a tribulation, it has a negative connotation with it. You're thinking like, how can I find joy in a negative situation? Well, the great thing about God is, because God is a way maker, because God is a man that shall not lie, because God said in his word that the weapons may form, but they will not prosper, this tells us that even though we may have attacks of the enemy, even though we may go through things that seem unbearable, or we may go through things and say like, "Hey God, why me? Why me?" I challenge you to say, "Why not me?" Because God already knew the things that were going to happen before they happened. He predestined these things. But the thing that he promises is that he's going to help us get over whatever that obstacle is. But we have to learn what perseverance is. Perseverance is being persistent despite of difficulty, despite of how hard it is, you keep going. Despite of how hard it is, you just keep going. You keep going hard. So you got to have that type of attitude when you're rolling with God. You can't be a wimp out here when you're rolling with God, because he's promising you like, "Look, even though I'm taking you through these obstacles, it's going to make you better. Even though you're going through some trials, some tribulations that you never faced before, it's going to make you stronger in your faith. It's going to make you and I closer, because you're going to depend on me more. You're going to cling on me like never before." So you have to be grateful for those trials and tribulations, because it does make the relationship between you and God stronger. Because you know what? You look back and you be like, "You know what, God? You did it back then. I know this is nothing. Right now it's hard, but I'm going to keep persevering through it. I'm going to keep going through it, because I know you got my back." There's a famous professional speaker. His name is Winston Clements. You can look him up on Facebook. A person like him, who, if you look at his physical appearance, because he was diagnosed with a disease called brittle bones disease, where his bones can easily break, this man travels all over the world, and he's married to his lovely wife. He travels all over the world speaking engagements out of the country, different places. He could have used his situation, what he went through, and been like, "I'm depressed. God doesn't love me." And by the way, he is a true believer of God and Jesus Christ. But he could have used that situation because of his physical abilities and been depressed and sad. But instead, he used that in fuel. God put a gift in him to speak to nations. So that's what I'm saying. When you persevere, you don't know where God can take you through the difficulty of your situation. So I encourage you, whoever you are, wherever you are, whatever it is that you face, and know that God can use that very thing that you see that's bad, that you see that's unbearable, that you see that you can't see the light of the tunnel, that he can turn that thing around and make you into something that you never thought that you would be. So I encourage you, my brothers and sisters. Y'all know I love you. Make sure you tune into the One in a Million show. I have a new time starting May 1st. I'm going to be airing on 2 o'clock p.m. So thank you so much. 1320 a.m. WCVG. I will see you there. God bless you all. Share this video with someone to encourage them. God bless.